Hi everyone, Squee here, and welcome to Let's Play Batman Arkham Knight. I've taken a little bit of time to get to this one, partly because I've had other things to play, and partly because I'd put the Arkham games down for a while, but I'm really, really excited to play this now. This is going to be a completely blind Let's Play. I know very, very little about this game, but I am so ready for it. It's actually been so long since I played a lot of the Arkham games that on my own time I actually went through all the games chronologically. I did Arkham Origins, then Asylum, then Arkham City. I just finished a few days ago. So I'm all caught up and ready to go. So I'm not going to take too long, but like I said, I'm very excited for this. I'm a huge Batman fan. I loved the cartoons when I was a kid. I loved all the movies. More recently, I've really enjoyed a lot of the comics, so I adore me some Batman. And I think the Arkham games are by far the best games they've ever made for Batman. And I have faith that this one will be good too, I hope. I have some faith. I think that my hype for video games has been tempered a lot in recent years, so I'm going to try and approach this with an open mind. And I do have some thoughts on what I do know about the video game. Like, I know some people think the Batmobile is tacked on or not Batman-like, and I'm sure I'll have plenty of time to find out for myself and get into my thoughts and views on it, because I have some that may or may not change depending on how the game plays. But yeah, I am so excited to play this game. Oh, you have no idea. I do have the Season of Infamy DLC, which adds more side missions to the game, which is cool. Which means I get to play the game for the first time like they were part of the Furl game, so that's going to be neat. I don't have any of the little side story missions that you do outside the game, because I heard they were really bad, so I didn't waste the money on them. So yeah, Arkham Knight. Oh boy. Alright, so I've been in the menu. That's all I've done. That's all I've seen is the menu. I've also downloaded some Batman costumes that were free. I basically downloaded all the free stuff. Because why not? Like I said, I have gone through the options, played around with it a little bit. I'm really sad. Really sad that there's no way to turn off the counter symbol above people's heads without playing New Game Plus. I hate the counter symbol. It breaks my immersion a little bit from the game. It won't ruin my experience, but I like not having giant blue squiggly lines above the heads of people when I play the game. I'm one of those crazy people like that. And it mystifies me why Rocksteady does not give you the option to turn those off. It just mystifies me. But oh well. We will deal with it, I suppose. So I looked online, I didn't see any way to do it. I'm playing this on the PS4, obviously, so, you know, there's no mods or anything that can change that. Oh, heck, let's just get into this, shall we? Let's do this. Oh, one thing. I'm making a promise to myself and to you guys right here. I am 100%ing this game. I 100%ed Arkham Asylum, but I never 100%ed City or Origins. Origins, it just wasn't worth it. Despite the fact that Origins was my favorite game out of the three, Asylum, City, and Origins. I know I'm the oddball in that, but I thought the story was amazing and the gameplay was the same as City. So, you know, if this gameplay is the same and the story is better, that's my favorite. But the Riddler challenges weren't that interesting. And Arkham City's Riddler challenges were actually really interesting, but I just never got them all. But this game, I'm gonna get them all. I assume there's Riddler challenges. There's been Riddler challenges in every game. So if they're there, I will get them all. This is a promise I'm making to myself. I don't know if I'll show it all in the Let's Play, but I might stream it all or something. I don't know. Anyway, but yes, promise to myself. I am making right now. Let's do this. Batman. I'm Batman. Oh, and it's on normal difficulty because it's the first time I'm playing the game.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you. So deep in my heart, got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time that I do, just the thought of you makes
am I supposed to do something here
before I begin?
Oh, was that me? Yeah, that's me. Well, I don't know. I mean, this is a pleasant picture. He's so happy. All right, what? Bye, Joker. Bon voyage. Miss you.
This is how it happened. This is how the Batman died.
Wait, seriously? Did we just spoil the ending at the start of the game? And freeze the game? Well! Well, I hope you guys enjoyed watching Batman Arkham Knight. Apparently, that's how Batman died. Maybe he caught on fire while the Joker was being cremated. I guess they're leaving it up to interpretation. You know, not giving you exactly the details. Hey, if Bioshock Infinite did it, why can't this game, right? Well, it's been a good time, everyone! Ta-ta. Until the next Batman. What the hell? What was that? Oh, no. This is how Batman dies. Well, I guess I can't really read too much into it because... Oh, see, now I'm worried, though. Like, oh, not worried. I'm curious because... Okay, on one hand, this is like the end of the trilogy, so if they're gonna kill Batman, it would be this game. But on the other hand, it's a comic book game. How many times do people die and come back and... I don't know! It's a weird way to start the game, though. I'll tell you that. Do I mind if Batman dies? Not really. I've read comics where he's died before. Like, I don't know, as long as they do it well, I don't mind. But why should I be talking about this before the story even starts? I don't know if that was the best way to start the game. I don't know. We'll have to see. I'm judging too harshly, too quickly, I think. Let's try this again, shall we? But I'll say this. If the story's done well and Batman dies, hey, kudos. All for it. Snake died. And, you know, that was a great ending to a game. I only don't like it when characters die when I roleplay as them. You know, like Mass Effect. Because that was my character. This isn't my character. This is Batman. Batman. Alright, we're gonna watch this again. Hey, is this New Game Plus? Is this New Game Plus? Because it feels harder. It feels harder than the first time. I tell you what.
But you have to rotate the other direction this time. Hang on.
I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats in my ear.
This has been a brilliant start to the Let's Play so far. Let me tell you. Burn, Joker! Burn! There you go.
Wait. Wake up to reality.
Oh. Well, that's cool. Okay. Can't stop. I stopped. This is a delightfully sadistic thing they're letting us do. Can I stop again? Yeah, that's creepy. Okay, I'm just gonna incinerate. What? There we go.
This is how it happened. This is how the Batman died.
Through random bugs and glitches? Yeah, I can see it. And there we go, folks. I just beat New Game Plus. Oh, that was tougher. That was tougher, let me tell you. What the hell's going on? I'll be back, folks.
I've got you under my skin.
Okay, so this is the next day, actually. Turns out it wasn't the game, it just had downloaded wrong, or something corrupted when it downloaded, so I had to delete it and re-download 48 gigabytes of game. So that took time. But we're back, and I think it's working now. Last time Joker? Maybe? I mean, even I'm starting to feel bad for him.
This is how it happened. This is how the Batman died.
Someone set him on fire? I mean, that's pretty brutal. Good lord. Aha!
9 months ago, no Joker freezing. Was cremated. I pressed the button and burnt the evil bastard myself. And then we waited. Gotham braced itself for the inevitable power struggle. But it didn't come. Crime actually fell. Deep down, I knew war was coming. I was just waiting for someone to pull the trigger.
Okay. Oh, hey, I can move.
No problem.
Oh, hey, I'm a cop.
Oh, thanks, honey. So, what'll it be? Your usual?
Sure.
Okay, chicken salad with no dressing.
No, you know what? Make it waffles. With a side of bacon. Don't tell my wife.
Whatever you say, officer.
No, seriously.
Oh, and if you want some more coffee, just shout.
Don't tell my wife.
Hey, I'm sorry to interrupt your dinner, Officer, Owens.
Uh-huh.
But there's a guy smoking over there, in the corner booth.
Oh.
Wait here. I'll have a word.
Well, yep. This was not exactly how I expected to start the game. But all right, then. You know, we're going from, taking down Clayface and the Joker.
He's down the back.
To stopping secondhand smoke victims. Just like a sequel should be, the problems are bigger and broader in scope.
One guy got $75,000 in compensation. Can you believe that?
Arkham City was supposed to be jail.
Strange turned it into a concentration camp. Yeah, but it was $75,000 of our tax money. And that's just one guy.
All he lost was an arm. Hang on. We're paying for this?
Nope.
It must have been.
Damn yeah, right.
Criminals in this town have found a new way to mug that.
Huh.
Class action lawsuits.
You want to blame someone, blame Hugo Strange. Protocol 10 was wrong. Now we're paying for his mistake.
Oh, is this Halloween? Hey, that's why there's so many masks and stuff. I get it.
Maybe they should have got sent to Arkham City in the first
place.
That's a joke, right?
No. Compensating criminals? That's the joke.
You can't just execute people, man. Some of those guys have barely done anything wrong.
Look, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that if you get sent to prison and the prison warden happens to be a maniac who wants to rain fire down upon every criminal he can find, that maybe, just maybe, that's karma.
I wasn't karma?
Karma?
I got early release. Seems like a fair deal to me.
Yeah, a bunch of criminals back on our streets. And we're paying them for the privilege.
Oh, come on, you don't really think this? It's barbaric. We have to respect the law.
Sorry, I want to listen to this. And then,
we did respect the law. We're not inmates. We're not Hugo Strange, as far as I'm concerned. The compensation fund should have begun and ended with Strange's personal bank account.
Prison warden, you don't scare people like that.
All right, what else we got? Whatever conversations.
That's right, canceled. Albert King's big comeback fight. No refunds. Idiot. The Gotham Goliath backing out of a fight? I don't care if he was in the hospital.
No.
It never would have happened in the old days.
Yeah. Not the Gotham Goliath.
He'd have been sorry. But can you imagine it? Albert King up against Teddy Grant? Strength versus speed? Stamina versus footwork? The Goliath versus the Wildcat? Idiot. $70. Yep, each. All right, bye.
Aw, you poor guy.
Besides, I wasn't afraid. I'm Batman.
I'm Batman. What are you doing? What are you doing? Playing a game? Playing a game? Are you playing a game? Aw.
How old was he anyway?
He's just been sitting there, staring out the window.
I will get to him in a moment, sir. I am busy. Alright. Hi. Any juicy gossip? I'm a cop. It's okay. You can tell me. What about you guys? What about you? Anything? Anything? Whoa. Okay. What's this? You want to earn money quick? We're looking for human trials. Well, that sounds pleasant. Uh-huh. Alright. Is that it? Is that all the, Whoa, what's this? Seat yourself, eat me. Nice. Guys, by the way, I should probably mention, I'm going to take my sweet, sweet time with this game, because it's the last Arkham game, and I'm going to enjoy it to the fullest. Hi. How's it going? How's it going? You got something right there. You got something right there. Don't act like you can't hear me. Yeah! Talking to you. Right there. You got the thing. All over your collar. You see that? It's purple. Look, I'm... Fine. No one appreciates the work I do for the city.
If you got the cash, now's the time. I wasn't afraid. Look, I gotta go. Talk to you later.
Alright. What else we got? You guys having a good time? Good. Who should kick whose butt?
Last year they just threw a bunch of eggs at the house.
Uh-huh. Anything else?
Oh, man. We spent it all. All of it? All your compensation? Every cent.
Thank you, Hugo Strange. If I'd known I'd make so much money out of it, I'd have let him try and kill me a few more times.
Well, if Batman hadn't stopped him, we wouldn't have gotten paid off.
You're right. A toast to Batman. There's just one problem.
Yeah?
I'm kind of broke.
I don't really know why it would happen, but I got my payout last Friday, and then things get kind of blurry. And now I owe six guys money. One of them threatened to send a tally man after me. The tally man? Bad news. Guy's a pretty good shot.
Hmm.
I heard he took out some guy's kneecaps in Arkham. From Blackgate.
No, okay, I know. So what am I gonna do now? Well, you think I can take him?
Think you can get close?
You could pay him.
Oh, crap, I'm a dead man. Thousands of dollars, guys, and I blew through it in a week.
You need to make some money, quick.
Yeah, no one's hiring. I mean, yeah, there's legit gigs going, but no one wants to hire an ex-con.
And when it comes to our specialized areas of expertise, it's all gone quiet since the clown died.
Well, I wouldn't know about that, boys. But if you're interested in honest work, I might be able to set you up.
What do you got for me? I'll take anything. bouncer, security guard. Construction.
Waste disposal.
Ugh, you're kidding.
You want to take your chances with a sharpshooting debt collector? That's fine with me.
No, 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 no. Please, I'll do it. If they'll take me.
Oh, yeah, they'll take you. Hell's Gate Waste Disposal Services is committed to offering everyone, especially ex-cons, equal opportunities.
And what's the boss like? Sounds like a do-gooder.
Two bosses, actually. One's all right, smart. The other guy's a bit of a hard ass.
All right, when can I start?
Tomorrow night, or the offer's off the table.
Pretty short notice, man.
Too bad. Look, we've got three big scores, by which I mean totally legit above-board waste disposal gigs going down. Now, we need men, big, tough guys, to help us move all that lovely
theater. Oh, yeah, of course.
And,
okay.
Now, you can never be too careful in this town, so we need a couple of crack shots to help us defend all that totally worthless garbage from any vermin. You get me?
Not for nothing, but you're making this waste disposal sound pretty exciting.
Now, there's a chance we might be needing to move said Bader pretty quickly. So we're gonna need a driver who can, you know, help us get away in time.
Wait a second.
Just show up at my place, all right? Before five.
Yeah. Did somebody order the pork?
Wait a second. Hey, do they offer overtime? Because, honestly,
What can we do for you this fine evening?
I could use some extra.
If you don't mind,
some extra cash.
Really should get back to contemplating our menus.
All right. Let's go over here real quick, see if anyone else is talking. Hi. Hi.
What? You can't trust me? We shouldn't talk about this here. What if someone hears? I get in trouble. No one's listening. Come on.
Yeah, no one's listening.
It's about work. This is about the bank. Come on, Sarah. I thought it was personal. Just listen, okay? So, the other day, I'm working down in the Kingston branch.
Uh-huh.
One, and this lady comes in.
Yeah?
She's dressed all expensively. Designer labels, dark glasses, you know? And she asks for my boss. But my manager's sick that day. So I tell the lady, and she looks at me all, like, all panicked. Then she looks outside like she's nervous.
Okay.
I ask her if I can help, and she just throws this envelope on my desk. So she wants to make a deposit and walks out in a hurry like I threatened to call security.
What was in the envelope?
$500,000. And she just left it? That's not even the weird part. There's an account number written on the envelope, right? So I look it up, and it says not in database. I had no idea. I'm starting to get a little panicked, sitting there with $500,000 that I can't explain.
What does that mean?
So I go to Annie, she's been there forever, and show her the number. She says it's old, like way old, and I should go check down in the archives.
The archives?
The paper accounts, from before everything went electronic.
Uh-huh.
You still keep those?
Yeah, and now I know why. So I go down to the storage room and start looking through all these dusty filing cabinets. It's all out of order, so I'm literally going through the accounts one by one to find it.
How long did that take?
God knows. I think I've still got dust in my hair. Anyway, eventually I find it.
Uh-huh.
The matching account number.
Ooh.
That's it?
No, see, this is the weird part. All those other paper accounts stopped being updated 10 years ago. Like I said, now we just go straight into the database. But this account which didn't even have a name on it, which doesn't have any electronic record, deposits every month.
So, what does that mean?
It means my boss is up to something illegal.
So what did you do?
Nothing. Hid the envelope in my safe and gave it to my boss the next day. Said the client had specifically requested I do that.
That's it? You didn't even call the police? Seems kind of wrong to ignore it.
Easy for you to say. Let's drop it. Waitress will be by any sec. I'm not losing my job, and I'm definitely not going to upset the wrong people.
Do you two, look, you're good friends, right? Do you normally not look at each other when you're talking? Because that's just weird. Oh well. Hey, how's it going? What's up? What you doing? Huh? I need some help? I am an officer. I'm the law. Oh, fine. All right, I think we've exhausted the conversations here. Let's go protect these fine citizens from smoking. Hi, how's it going? I'm Officer Owens. Sir, your pack is, sir. Sir, you're supposed to, light the cigarette after it's out of the carton? He must be new to this. Sir!
Excuse me, sir. There's no smoking in here.
What? This isn't normal? That'd be funny, like, someone plays this game and they're like, oh, whoa, hey, I was talking. They don't notice anything different because that's what they always see. Ow, hey, stop, ow. In the brain pan.
This demonstration used just 5 ounces of my latest toxin. Tomorrow, this will seem like child's play. Gotham, this is your only warning.
Scarecrow's threat worked. Yesterday, there were 6.3 million people in Gotham City. Today, not so many. The only people left on the streets are the sort that enjoy the chaos.
Gotham's finest.
Scum. Criminals. And worse. Not enough good people left to stop them. It took just 24 hours for us to lose control of the city. Tonight, Gotham's relying on one man to save us all.
Neat.